with that Terrorblade pickup.
I'd say talk about it pretty quickly. We've got a lot of smoke movement coming into smoke movement, so they'll break each side. Pylite dies up the hill. There you go, the Shards pushing him into the tier 1 tower, but Glimpse, Poppy leveled it up, and the Sunstrike's coming in. That's actually trying to help out from Fnatic. That won't help Pylite die. On the run up the hill, the Gust is there, and that's going to be mid 1 getting the kill with the laser. You're in some ways, even when you do have like a VS core in the offlane. But do you actually feel like after that first blood now that it's not as greedy? Like Abed, you said he's gonna play the catch-up game later on, but he still seems to be pretty neck and neck with the Tinker. Glimpse on bottom, Eternal Envy coming back to the fight. Pilot Eye wants to help out. Puppy is low, but the Shards locking in Eternal Envy. He wants to kill on Puppy, maybe killing his former teammate, but it won't happen. Ace, the Danish Terrorblade is able to bring him down. So 2-0 to Team Secret as far as the kill count.
You always want to contest between the towers as these supports. But versus Tusk, versus Disruptor, these are those punishers. You have to be very careful of.
Ensnare is out, March the Machines. Try and do its work to at least give some real repair damage. Tusk, our snowball, was the only thing that was going to save him, but Yapzor just can't get there in time. Pylite Die finding the perfect moment as we hit nighttime and
quite far behind that of the Beastmen. They're getting close to half.
They're smoking a gang top. They want Universe. Level 2 glimpses up from Poppy, so he does have the range to pull back Universe. That's where Universe starts with a roar, begins his run, the reflection units chasing him off, and here comes your snowball forward. The Shards catching both of them from Yapzor, but will it be good or not? Universe is still there in the back line thanks to the glimpse, so they split up. DJ goes one way. Ace able to finish him off, and Universe running circles now. The wall is there from Poppy. The axes will kill him off, and Universe's high movement speed, he has enough speed to outrun the Tuskar Shards. Maybe not enough to get through this. Snowball coming in. Almost enough damage. Fodder is so low. And Universe one-charging and bottling through it all. They want to get the top net worth. Here comes the Shards again, but it's well off target.
Ace top.
Ace, yeah. Where's that Sunstrike? It's still coming up. It's off cooldown in 1 second time. So here it comes with the stun, but it connects. Ace will fall down. Barter try to create space, now the Ravage is blown for not much more. Envy does have swap available. He's just on the edge of the range and he'll snap him up, pull him back. You can break free of the magic missile, but the negative armor and the damage from Universe's Axis will do the work back in towards mid. Pilot died deep under the tier 1 tower. They're looking for a little bit more. And now, well, they've managed to catch out the Invoker. Glimpse back into the storm, doesn't have the range. Mid one with a double kill.
Not having a good time. He's almost same net worth as DJ.
Pylite Die is just walking straight in. He ensnares onto the Terrorblade, grabs up the Bounty Rune, and then Song of the Siren. They want to go again. There's no Sunstrike damage for 3 more seconds. They got to hold him there just a little bit longer. Eternal Envy has the magic missile. Ace wants to run out. Here's the Sunstrike perfectly on the left. So Ace is low, but sunders the target. Pylite Die. Now he drops on Universe on the run. The Shards will lock him in place. Pylite Die will die in the lane. Universe will die in the river.
Clutch timing from the supports to show up. Static Storm saving his teammates, saving off Ace there. The Roar wasn't able to get expended by Universe.
The TPs are coming in. Tinker to the front lines, but Eternal Envy underneath the Sentry Ward gets revealed. Farter was thinking about the Ravage. Now he does let it go. Eternal Envy actually swapped in. Pylite Die. The wall is there, but the Sunstrike will kill off Puppy. EE is still alive. The Rockers fly forward, but it connected onto Universe and not onto Eternal Envy. It becomes a 1-for-1 trade-off, even though the Tier 1 tower goes the way of Secret. The Tier 2 tower on bottom is still being peppered. This seems to be way too easy for Abed just to get more and more money. Like, I know it's the classic when you've got a whole bunch of stuns in your lineup, the Invoker Sunstrike's gonna get you connection. Yes, there's that Tinker Ward going to work. DJ's leaving it for Abed, but the Tusker snowball in! Yapzor flips him like a pancake. Abed's gonna go down. He wants more, but can they get to DJ in time, Puppy? No. Okay, yeah. Goodbye, DJ. Eternal Envy's in the neighborhood trying to get a return kill onto Yapzor. We're going tit for tat down on that bottom lane. They definitely know that Tinker Ward is up as Envy just attacks over the Fog of War tree line. How long do you leave it out? Like, do you also think about picking up the Skadi or something along along those lines before you get the BKB?
I think Manta BKB.
Oh, Song of the Siren. They will just look to catch the Tinker out, and they've got him. Mid one trapped in the trees. A lot of damage on the Pylite Die, but mid one still will go down to the big damage from the Invoker. Arbear with the Tornado. They'll flip him again. He wants to go Invis. Deafening Blast creates a space. 11-1 charge. No. They push him away, but now they pull him back in again to the Storm. But Arbear needs more space. The Ravage will not allow it. And Universe offers himself up. Roars quickly. Speaking of Roche, here come Fnatic. Mass Weapon Wards are down. Universe will summon all of the beasts, the creatures of the wild. And Eternal Envy with that Mask of Madness just does so much work. the Tuskar Sigil, scouts it out. They want to get rid of that, able to do it very, very quickly. But Fada, well, no Ravage. DJ blinks out, goes with a quick Hex. The Shards will lock Fnatic inside the pit. They still want to fight inside that Fog of War as DJ, Fada back in again. Tornado will pick him up and then drop him back down again. Fada gets the regeneration rune and then the snowball protection. He'll end up surviving, but they're rolling all the way up to Eternal Envy. Sunstrike's coming in. That'll kill off Fada with a follow-up roar. Yapsa will go down. Two heroes with the Ice Wall. It tries to create that buffer, and they'll swap him back into it. Eternal Envy all over Ace. They'll lose their big one. Down goes the Terrorblade. The Aegis Immortal will still crack on Eternal Envy. But Team Secret is in full retreat. If they can get back out, that Observer Ward gives good vision, but there's no stun for Universe available. In case we didn't realize, the enemy has vision around the Radiant top jungle. And they're 100% right. That marker is on the money here. Kozhi little fighting mid fighter. He's going to be burned dry. Roar is there up, and he's a little bit more damage with the Insanda. Hold him. The Ravage will buy some time. So DJ and Eternal Envy can be attacked, but they just swap them out. Tuskar Snowball, Yapsar mid one, staying on the back of Eternal Envy, but he has the vision. He's playing around. That's why the Sigil is there, but the Song of the Siren, the Rockers still keep flying. Eternal Envy
gets the Shadow Blade.
The Shadow Blade will trigger. They don't connect. Pylite Die will probably fall here. He's just continues to play around. This Observer Ward will die to the tower as Universe will run away. Metamorphs is done again. The Sunstrike, no! Puppy holds hands. I thought Yapsaw was going to be in trouble for that one, but still, a one-for-one trade out of that. Ravage burned once more.
He's just hunting.
Yep.
Well,
Puppy, he's walking over, puts down the Observer Ward, gets a lot of vision early on.
Abed pretty much got BKB now.
Oh, the Roar and the Sunstrike. Puppy protected once again. Yapsaw, right place, right time, rolling all the way forward towards Universe. Now both the supports a little bit too deep in, but it will work with Fada. It's four heroes with his Ravage and the follow-up Storm Wall. Envy had to keep running, but they'll glimpse him back into the Storm. The wall is still up. Eternal Envy will fall. And Team Secret, they were the ones initiated on. Fnatic wanted a quick kill and move on to the next, and it ended up being a two-for-one trade-off in favor of Team Secret.
And Envy, if you notice, he's gone for a bit of a different build. He's on the Orchid. So he's going to be going for that Bloodthorn.
Be good control over someone like Tinker. There's no way against it. Ace is in real trouble. They actually just dropped the Mass Effort Ward instantly. He's got no buyback for 72 seconds. The only upside right now for Team Secret is the Mass Effort Wards were already committed. So, march it up. No easy way for Fnatic to force the high ground. Roar on bottom lane. Another pick off. Yapsaw has to snowball, but Arbet, he ran so quickly in that Ghost Walk, and his Tornado is right on the money. Sunstrike, same as well. Yapsaw goes down. Two heroes with no buyback available.
Four.
Sorry, the three. The mass open wards.
He's pretty close to having the mana for it if you bring some mangoes. If he has like two mangoes, and then you get, because you essentially you get three arcane boot usages if you use it properly, so he should have the mana for all three.
Universe.
If they go for it.
Sunstrike's a little bit off target. The Roar's coming down. Mid one in the tree lines. Fada, there's a snowball save. The Ravage to connect. Pylai, Die, and Puppy. They're caught in the corner. Song of the Siren. Eternal Envy's trying to bring down Ace with the help of Arbet. They're able to do it, but it'll cost Eternal Envy his life. And the rest of them is the TP out. Mid one may look to fight a little bit more if they knew how long Arbet was hanging around. But a 2-for-2 trade-off, Terrorblade is down. Out the top lane again. Found the target. While we're looking at the stats, it's up on top. The Mass Effort Wards are down and mid one falls. They have the defensive.
They can't let Fnatic get this third Rosh.
Yep, they know it. That's why they're hanging around. Four heroes in smoke under the pit. Now Fnatic smoked up as well. They'll run in close. Fada, he doesn't want to initiate, or does he? Tuskar jumps in. Eternal Envy pops a BKB. Roar is on Ace in the back lines. He needs to get out of this one before he dies! He dies so quickly! The control is perfect. The buybacks are not committed. They're all on the run away from the Mass Serpent Wars. Tuskar will die on the hill. And Team Secret mid one swap back in again. Needs to blink once more. Able to do so. The Sunstrike, the Shackles. DJ's got him. Locked him and killed him. Eternal Envy with the triple kill. Fnatic will claim Roshan and everything that comes with it. Nubbed already jumped towards the mid lane. He's attacking the mid melee as well as range racks. Tinker is forced to buy back to defend this. He's now in range. Here comes DJ in through the front. Yapsaw, now's your moment.
There's
oh, is it? DJ,
two,
number one, number
three.
Two, number three, all down. It's the three Amigos. That's a lot more than three. They're just going to rip apart with the Mass Serpent Wards. How do you defend it? They haven't even got the Ravage off. Varda, he's waiting for the right time. At least Ace got his BKB off for the fight, but Arpen stands his ground, and this is over. Five heroes are basically falling. The buybacks are coming in thick and fast, but they're losing their base. The Mass Serpent Wards do the work. The Ravage will connect on four, but it's still not enough. The Ice Wall is down, and GG, well played. Fnatic has done it. They will take game one off this best of three winners bracket final.
And end it with just a casual 42.
Potential. If he's in the right place at the right time, it could be great. Not
all right. Envy Terrorblade, 12-2, their most successful hero combination. And I think it fits here. Wow.
A lot of this game is going to be on Ace. Sure.
Oh, yeah.
Fada's going to have a much better game, but I say this a lot when I see Ursus. This hero needs to snowball, and he doesn't have that. He doesn't have an incredible snowball because he's going to get pressured by a dual lane. It's not just going to be a Beastmaster down there, which he could run down.
Eye. Pick up, throw him back into mid one. Not close enough to the Remnant to get the extra damage in, but he'll go for a Happy Tree. Needs the regeneration, but Puppy's Fissure Block is there. And mid one claims the first blood.
And look at Yapzor. He's just following Pi.
But hitting him makes no sense. Like, Pilot Eye's got 6.6 HP regeneration. Bottom lane, Ace going after DJ. Puppy has already landed the Fissure Block down there. DJ moving through the tree line. One more clap. Needs another hit, and Puppy, he'll punch him, and Ace will swing in with the last claws. That's now two kills the way of Team Secret. It seems like one of those very few games where, like, a Terrorblade can't force this top lane. Like, you see, the second Eternal Envy triggers Metamorphosis, Varda shields and runs at him.
And this is why they picked this Abba, is to just put pressure on Terrorblade.
Wait, Eternal Envy, he's actually TPing out. Yeah, he's got telekinesis. He waited the maximum time, so Fada had more time to connect into him. And Eternal Envy, he's actually going to die here. One charges won't save him. He may be a little bit pissed about that, the fact he doesn't have his items on the courier. But bottom lane, perfect fissure. Ace kills off DJ. Arbed trapped in the tree line. Puppy now sees him, has the totem stun to give, and Yapzor, well, he may. No, one charges.
I mean, they took the top tier twos.
Yeah,
so
you just control the jungle, right?
This might be where you see Envy go do the old school Envy play, where
Puppy.
He goes plays opposite jungle.
He can actually fissure block him in. Eternal Envy's out too far. You may have Sunder available, you may have to use it, but you can't. You're controlled completely. Oh boy. Well, this could be a very, very quick game too. Pylai Dai is stalking mid one. Puppy right behind him. Here comes your TP. And Pylai Dai lines up the stun, able to connect onto mid one. Illuna fly out, but Echo Slam from Puppy finds the time for mid one to get really aggressive into DJ. Puppy is low on life. We brought down by the breathe fire of Arbed, but the stolen roar from Yapzor used on the Dragonite. Ursa wants to attack into him, able to do so. Remember, he soaked up this Aegis Immortal and a desire to fight. Blink off cooldown in 2 seconds. 1 second. Where does he go? He wants to get Universe if possible. Yapzor saw him for half a second. Stop to attack. Ace just blink claps. And down goes Universe.
Look at that build by Ace. The 4 points in the Earth Shock.
But Arbed's getting more space in the bottom, so his money for the BKB is still coming at a half-decent timing.
But they need their Terrorblade to be big in this game, especially when they're playing versus this Tri-Core that's having such an excellent time.
But there's no way they survive, right? Unless you actually have that BKB on the DK. Yeah. Eventually, Secret's just going to go high ground on you.
He needs BKB, but it's really this Terrorblade needs so many items in this game now to catch back up. It's already Aghanim's finished on Ursa. Storm's got Orchid finished. The Radiance is about to be done on Fada. And again,
Storm managed to even kill Nyx Assassin right now. Yeah, the jump in. Pilot Eye attempted to go for the courier. Unfortunately, his 65 base damage is nowhere near enough. Back down towards the bottom lane. Ace, ready to fight. He has Aghanim set for revival. The mirror image is making it more difficult. Fada, there goes the borrowed time. Triggered off on him. They still want to fight. Here comes Ace. The double climb. Roar is out from Universe. Ace waiting it for the moment, and mid one in from the side. Arbed, the last dragon slayed. Envy already goes for the Sunder, bringing mid one down low, but a double fissure, still no follow up. When mid one's this low, he does not want to fight. So he jumps away again from the reflections.
He's gaining on him.
You just watching the fight? I'm just kidding, they were within 100 gold between DJ and Envy.
Yeah.
They were within 100 gold of each other. Well, they're gonna go in. Pylai Dai is low. Ace, however, in trouble. Has the Aegis Immortal. Has also enraged. Doesn't want to burn it just yet. Here comes Fanda in from the west. Yapzor waiting in the back lines. Has Impale in 1 second time, but Pylai Dai will catch him there. Where is this Impale? Fissure from Puppy. Nice position. Impale follow up. Fanda. There goes your borrow time. Triggered out. Universe. A throw back. Actually, a throw in. Catching out Nyx Assassin, but mid one! All the way across. across the top of the fight and the Echo Slam from Puppy. They need more control, but the stun is still there. Mid one back into the fight, into the back lines, trying to catch out Universe. Bit of an even trade-off so far, or group up whoops, maybe not. Not when DK, I'll bet. I thought he was going to get more than that, but Aze is too strong and they couldn't close the distance with mid one.
And that's the biggest fight for Fnatic at this point in the game too, because that was the Ags reveal from the Coddle during daytime with the gem too.
All right, double damage room for mid one. Gonna start beating into that mid-tier three tower. They break the Lincoln Sphere, mid one instantly jumps back out again. Meanwhile, Fada hitting that top tower. Yeah, you cursed that tower. And now mid one in again with the Shiva's Guard. Envy, that BKB comes so late, but he can at least thunder Yatsura. Yatsura thunders him back. The stuns are nice from Fnatic, but it won't be enough. A steal to a steal, and they want to get back to the objective base gaming. Tier three tower must fall with the DK buyback. He does not have Dragon Form, however, but the Shadowblade initiation, he doesn't have that either. The Secret have already left.
They're not looking to slow down. It's still night. It's nighttime for another minute, so they want to try to claim advantage of that.
If they can capture TJ, this is going to be a big part of doing it. And
in.
Jump in. Well, that's not a real one. That's not a real one. This isn't a real one. Fish is going to be off the mark. All right, let's just keep killing off all the fake ones. 40 gold apiece. Sure.
You see how Fada is actually turning his Radiance off in these situations too, so that the reflection...
Nyx doesn't stun him.
The Nyx doesn't stun him, the reflection doesn't hurt as much.
So at least borrowed time gets burnt.
Yeah.
Not exactly what he wants. There's the Fisher hit. That's what Puppy wanted. Coddle will fall. Follow up Echo Slam. Two heroes down. Buybacks there from the Keeper of the Light. And Eternal Envy. Sunder, it's available if he gets down low still. Fada, not a healthy man. Ace struggling to run out of this one. And there's your Beastmaster Roar, but no. They just dispel out with the Enrage. He still has the cheese. Have to remember that one too. Yampsaw's the one. Mana leaked in Eternal Envy. Wants to fight. Picked up, throwing down. They're going to find the real one. They found him as well. Push back up. The Orchid won't pop him. They turn for the hit onto mid one. So low, and he does finally die. 942 gold for this. Yampsaw, what have you got, son? Thunder.
Just refresh the Sunder Steel.
As you said, Refresher and she's being burned already. But Roshan's the critical moment now. Fnatic have the greatest thing ever though. They took a fight before Roshan came up, which means that all the lanes are actually pushed in nicely. They have very, like, there's not much risk for them to come out like this, and it's very difficult for Secret to fully read where
and
they are.
It's daytime and they have vision
they
of mid one
Puppy
right now.
They're gonna try and kill on Puppy. Where's the extra help? Mid one roared up. They actually triggered his Lincoln Sphere. They want to get rid of Puppy before the Echo Slam can be pushed out, but it won't happen. Mid one with the BKB jumping into the middle of him. He wants that Keeper of the Light down, but doesn't have it. The stun chaining here from Pylai Dai. Mid one doesn't have any kind of mana. Arbet and Envy, they can stand their ground and fight, but mid one back into the mid lane. They have the Ursa. They have to cut him, drop him down low, and Puppy in for the Echo Slam with the double down the cause. It's the timing, it's the moment, it's the kills, it's Team Secret. There's still a 2-for-3 trade off. Pilot A will TP out in time. Illusion's doing their work. So here comes Fada, just wants to bring down the range racks, and they will easily be able to do this. The top melee racks, which is also under siege, so it's a split engagement, but up on top, Ace. Oh, Yapsaw was moving in very, very quickly to come and help him out. Envy has already burnt that BKB of his, so no more protection. Lincoln's also triggered out. You can see him just playing in fear in the back lines. The fish up, three-man Echo Slam onto four! The Illumina will give a little bit more life back, but it really will never be enough. Fnatic under their tier four towers are dying, dropping like flies. Ace wants more. He'll have the cheese available if he wants to just pop that and go for another kill. But Fnatic, they just got slammed.
Perfect by Puppy. That's how you close the game out, with style.
Yeah.
1k per minute lead, and a 50 minute game.
You know the stupid thing
is, I don't think I've ever seen that actually.
They're buying time with the Blinding Light mana leaks, because they're draining him out quite heavily. So Arbez back in, and yeah, Team Secret have realized they cannot finish the throne before the Nyx Assassin is back. Fortifications up, but now, okay, maybe pull them into a fight. The Vortex dragging back Universe. He needs more space, but he doesn't have it. Gem is down, but buyback is available. He'll end up burning it right now. Ursa Warrior, remember he's still got that cheese up. Fada just wants the Megas to be available. Yampsaw's on 275 HP, sticking around for the fight. Arbez needs more life. 14-1 charges will do it. Mid one and Yampsaw, they're so low in the back lines. Pylai die. A great double stun. Varda, there's that borrowed time coming back into work again. The root is on the Ursa Warrior. It's the stolen creep. Will it be enough? Ursa still wants to keep the run going. They're getting more life. Pylai die. Where's that stun? It'll actually reach the Ursa, but is there enough follow-up? You have to breathe fire, but in rage, they stun him. They have to wait it out. Half a second, but the Fisher from Pumpy is back once more. The breathe fire, the blink ace will end up dodging the spill radius. Poor DJ is the man doing the solo defense, but Fnatic know they need a kill. This chase has been going on so long. Again, borrowed time, back off cooldown. Pylai Dai cannot reach with a stun, and the Fissure block will cut off any chance Fnatic have of chasing further.
And Secret will just...
They burnt everything previously.
Now they're giving it to Puppy. Now they want that control. After that, you better give it to Puppy.
Yeah, makes sense. Means he'll have a double BKB too because he's put a 10-second one. Here comes Fnatic. They want to fight, but the stun's in the back line. Just so good from Puppy. And he was only a Fissure one as well. He'll BKB and hide in the tree lines. But without a Beastmaster, Puppy wants to reset. Smoke will allow this to happen. Envy, there's your Sunder going to work, but Yapzorg sunders him straight back. There's your jump on the back lines. GG, well played. Fnatic tried to come for surprise gank, but it will not work. And we are going to a game three, the deciding matchup to see who can win this battle between Team Secret.
Wow. So... this is offlane DK, I told you.
Mid lane, Pylai Dai is still looking for that rotation around the back. Mid one's trying to get up in Arbed's face, but with Yapzor sitting behind him, you were saying it before in the earlier games of this series, that Yapzor is kind of like that mid laner that just sits there the entire time. Ensure mid one.
That's pretty much what he does. He plays around the mid lane more than anything. They actually really don't play around Ace too much on their supports. It sometimes is Puppy, but for the most part, they sit around mid and just keep E. And we will see Fada, since he can't lane versus Razor in a 1v1, it's all about the creep pull.
Cold snap, Pylai die, Yapzor needs to keep punching him and body blocking him. Pylai's in trouble. There's that early tornado, and Yapzor with the bonus damage.
It's boss
secures
watch.
A first blood, and
gonna follow suit.
But watch. Right now he's not looking anywhere past phase boots.
No, it's
at the beginning.
Phase earn, and then we'll see what the build is after.
DJ doing a lot of damage. There's 2 points up in battery assault with the firestorm. Puppy will burn. How's the vision game look like? Okay, vision game's not that great. Spirits down. DJ wants to walk straight through him. The double Fissure from Yapzor will connect. Arbed, Cole snapped up. Need a little bit more damage up the hill, but Pylai dies here too. And Envy starts his TP, and when the plans are field, they'll have enough damage. He'll invoke up the Quas, then goes inside the Ghost Walk, but it won't matter. The Sentry Ward, which was there to do the D-warding in the first place, is what reveals him. And the denial on the Observe Ward can at least happen. Pylai die. It looks like rotations everywhere. Arbed's coming bottom. So Ace going to try and just push Universe out.
Universe has a Vanguard though. 1500 HP, you're not pushing him out.
Yeah.
Ace.
Where's that TP? There's the pit to start with. Tearing Chains, level 3. There's a long time for Ace to be trapped there, but then the Fear, Arbed, and Universe back up. The Spirit Committal. Arbed. May commit quite heavily into Yap, so they know he's just farming there. DJ closes the distance, but can get close enough just yet.
Arbed's here though, stalking, and they do not know that Arbed's down here still.
Yapzor looking for the stun, actually waited it nicely, baked it out with his initial totem. But the EMP, going to keep everybody else at Puppy. I think he's still looking towards Arbed. Doesn't want this regen. Oh, okay. Magic Missile will chase him. Yapzor's here! The cogs! DJ creates enough space. Yapzor's trying to fidget, trying to get something back in return. They can at least lock in DJ, but they don't have enough damage while he's locked there. Meanwhile, up on top, Varda goes down.
Yeah.
12 minutes into this game, and Fada's like looking at this going, I am not a knight. This is the ultimate beast. And the fairy tale doesn't work where I get the kill. In fact, I get rooted all the way down the bottom, then chained, and now DJ will come into battery assault him as well. Universe will get the kill. The T1 town belongs to Fnatic.
Top as well, Ace.
Oh, Envy's actually stealing the damage from the bear. Ace wanted the kill over on Pylai Dai. Yapzor has to commit the Fissure to keep Eternal Envy exactly where he is, but the hookshot in from the side. Yapzor again in a horrible position.
Fnatic just making...
I love this move from Fnatic. Like, Arbet instantly turns on the flame guard, goes down towards the bottom lane to add pressure into the tier 2 tower. Because he could see Fada with the dragon form looking to add pressure to the mid. That tier 1 tower is pretty low, so Lone Druid's having more fun up here with Universe. With the sadder Hadoukens, he's got a little bit more damage. Universe gonna put down the root, locking up the army of Ace. Arbet does his TP as well. Spirit Camino, does he want to go through the tree line? He does not. Now he does, over the trees. Here comes Razor as well, but Tornado up in the air. Mid one drops the EMP too. Arbet, a little bit of trouble. He's actually bone dry, and Envy's on the wrong side of the tracks. Rooted up, the double stun from Pylai die. It will not create enough space. Team Secret bring 5 heroes to this top lane. Fnatic were looking to do exactly the same thing.
So pretty interesting. I guess the way he's trying to use the Dominator is just to be able to split push and take towers even faster, because he just jumps into true form, pops the battle cry, and he ends up actually quite hard. You see how low he brought Universe there?
Yep.
Interesting build coming out. Poppy.
Nice stun.
Getting found by Pi.
Yep. There's support coming over, however, but Hawkshot, DJ goes in, but he's locked in with 3 heroes. That's not to make battery salt effective, but it makes Underlord effective. The perfect pit, the perfect firestorm. And you're gonna lose 2 heroes. A 1-for-1 trade-off.
Did anyone else build Arcane Boots on the side of Fnatic? Alright, they did at least on Pi, so they have to have at least 1 or 2 sets to be able to play versus EMP in teamfights, because otherwise, you're all just out of mana.
It always seems so silly to see Arcane Boots on the line, however.
Oh,
mid one.
Arbet.
Yeah, he just slides forward. The call snap and the urn charges makes it almost impossible for Arbet to really just jump himself away from this. Slide of fist in 1 second time. Combine it to spirit out. Urn is still ticking him down. Sunstrike on the positioning. Arbet will fall. A level 2 Sunstrike will end up killing. And all the way home. Could have actually joined his teammates in the bottom lane to take out that tier 2.
But much closer game this time around, though. So it's less than 1k gold advantage. The experience is also negligible, about 2k.
It's coming back after Team Secret have just tried to change the tempo of this game. Since the Blink Dagger arrived over on Fada, Pylai Dai fails the Blink, but Fada also fails the stun, so now Fada fails the Blink. Nice hook comes in, Puppy swaps him back out once more to take it for the team. Buy the space for mid one, who drops down very, very low. He has EMP Tornado, actually he has Cold Snap Tornado invoked. I think at this point, when Fnatic bring that many numbers into the lane, you're happy for it. Ace almost took the tier 2 tower up on top of Arbet. He at least can commit to kill off the bear, but he wants Arbet. Envy will take the bear, just do the extra damage, get the bonus 300 gold efficiency as Ace Savage Roar. But they kept their distance nicely. So he'll go up into the trees. Rocket gives him the vision. And that's a good kill. Meanwhile, back in mid lane, Fada, very, very low. Ice Wall makes it impossible for Pylai Dai to actually run away from mid one or to keep up with Fada, who's coming back in for the kill. He's looking for the Earth Spike, but he can't do it. The call snap makes it impossible to channel. A level 2 Echo Slam. If they can get some level of information, the Wave of Terror will provide this and be ready for the jump. They know they're in there. Yamsor, he's high enough up that the rocket from DJ, it didn't actually scout him out. Wait for it, wait for it, wait for it, and slam in time, almost there. Now they see a little bit more. The plasma field are connected. He can't blink anymore. He'll go for the fissure. Roshan's at 200 life. Yamsor will not jump in. He'll blink away instead. And what could have been amazing was mediocre at best. Yamsor just needs to TP, but he can't. On cooldown for 5 more seconds. That's your blink reveal. Roshan goes the way of Fnatic. Aegis onto the Ember, and full Radiance as well.
Got the Orchid available too. Abed could go down twice here to the rotation stun.
Puppy's in the neighborhood, however, and so is Yamsor. Quick little stun, and Abed mid one. They break the Aegis, the Immortal. Underlord. He's actually jumping into the bottom lane. So they're gonna try and commit a little bit harder. That's why Arbet's coming underneath the tier 2 tower. Puppy still has the swap available, but here comes DJ in through the rear. The swap is already out, but he actually pulled him in to the middle of the cogs. That wasn't part of the plan. Eternal Envy gets a triple kill.
He's on a monster kill. He's 9-1 on this Razor. That was great by a Universe there to join, because they're like, oh man.
The rooting on the DK. DJ's making sure they can't get in too close. Can they defend this? They need to keep the melee racks alive. Puppy comes to the front lines. Arbet, as well as Universe, they're committing, and they do bring down the melee racks. The Savage Roar trying to hold Arbet in position a little bit longer. The chaining stuns, they keep him going. Now DJ hooks in the space creator, but the Orchid Silence, the perfect timing to kill off the Ember Spirit. Ace will get a double kill out of this, but they just lost their melee racks on bottom. The Observe Ward may have scouted out the Bloodthorn, but here comes Yapzor. Pitcher to begin with. Bloodthorn onto Universe. Hookshot forward from DJ, but now he's isolated. They'll swap out the heroes, and this is now just a simple one-by-one pickoff. And you know Team Secret, they want more. That's why Tornado Search from mid one won't find his target. The Savage Roar will cancel the TP of Pylai Dai, and mid one will get the double kill. Two heroes without buyback. A big one in Universe to bring down.
And Ace
That's
is
his
now...
first death of the game.
Yeah, and Ace is now here to play.
The creep wave's coming up behind him, the bear in, farther into dragon form.
Look at
and
that.
Ace is plus 298 on top of his 106. Eternal Envy to the front lines, swap back in from Blockbeat.
Oh,
Envy's down, he'll have buyback available, but the Bloodthorn's on the Ember Spirit. Arpez down as well. Are they going to force buybacks on two of the cores? They only got it out from Razor so far. And Hawkshot, DJ in through the side. Maybe he regrets this. Barter's quite tanky, even with that urn on top of him. It's not even the urn, it's actually the Spirit Vessel, so maybe not so tanky. But the VS Spirit is fighting back. The Tier 4 towers are under siege back in Team Secret's base. They don't get exactly what they're looking for out of this. So he can just stand in the fight.
He doesn't, I mean, he dies so quickly if he does get Bloodthorn.
We'll see if he can stand through this. Team Secret, they're smoked up, rotated around the north side. A really good position for mid one if he can get a good hit, and there's the blink forward. They want DJ out. The Pit of Malice doesn't actually work. The fish cancels him out way too early, but the hookshot forward, it only connected on the bear. Arbed doesn't hit his Sleight of Fist Searing Chains combination. The BKB will wear off in 2 seconds time, and this immunity will be gone. Universe gets a nice double pit, but will it be enough for the double Searing Chains? It may almost be, but Farda finds the back lines up inside the lane. Almost the kill. The line will die from just the fall, scared of heights, and they move their attention towards DJ. Farda inside the cogs, trapped in there with him, and they swap Envy back in once more. The Bloodthorn is out. Three heroes down for Fnatic, but the critical thing, none of them have buyback. Fnatic going the long way around, up through the river. The rocket will reveal the angle. Dimension revealing Puppy. Doesn't see much more than that. Too many invis heroes. Sentries are going down. The Pit of Malice catching Fada. He'll go invis with the Shadow Blade up into the trees. Sentries on perfect positioning in the lane. The creep wave started attacking Fada. He walked right into it with the Finger of Death. Hookshot keeping out Yapzor, so he can't really help. But the DK's alive for the moment. Eternal Envy in the thick of it with the Echo Slam. And Lisa keeps Fnatic on the back lines. But Envy slowed down, but it's still not enough. BKB's being burnt massively.
Envy's Blink
Dagger. Only the ES dying.
Envy's Blink did work there. He closed the gap onto Ace and he got like 157 damage or so. So they actually were a bit afraid to fully engage into the fights because Ace is majority of their damage because Fada got brought so low.
They're looking to fight top. Ember Spirit mid-one. Very quickly back to the Spirit, and mid one's in trouble. Support is there from Ace, but the stuns, they chain long enough. Invoker, do you want to buy back? The Static Link is on Ace. They're on the run out of here. Farda's pushing in the top lane while all this is going on, but there's 280 points of damage stolen by Eternal Envy. He just wants to hit Ace once, but Ace still walking around with a cheese. Envy blinking inside the base. He gets feared out. Can Puppy hold him in here? He's got swap available, and he'll swap him out, and the Tornado, no return ticket, punched by Eternal Envy. Instead, he'll be punched down by every single member of Team Secret that's
Puppy's,
alive.
Puppy swaps this game are out of control. He saves Farda in the mid initially. So mid one looks like he's gonna buy boots and travel, join his team in the mid.
Swap,
Puppy! Stun.
So long, Envy, he's gonna go down! 100 seconds, buyback is available. Farda gonna attack in, the Pit of Malice slows it down. Here comes your buyback from Eternal Envy, but melee racks will fall. Farda's taking care of the range racks. They're gonna rotate up towards the top. They want two lanes of racks. They'll take the tier 3 tower very easily. Lone Druid going into his big bear form. He knows the timing. The BKB's being burnt.
Oh,
and now
God.
It's going to be Universe that gets mopped up. He was meant to be the big ass tank, but now they jump in deeper. Eternal Envy. BKB will protect him alive to see a lot of damage
Secret
out of the hands
dying.
Of Ace. But this is the problem. Yeah, the throne is going down. But Echo Slam! Yapzor jumps in. Goodbye, Pylai Dai. And goodbye, Eternal Envy. 2 minutes on the sideline. Universe, he's going in. He's going for the GG. He's on the back. Of the range creep, Arbed's here as well. Fnatic eventually doing this. They're going for the full GG. Mid ones come for the defense. Mortification's not there. Fnatic got it. They've gone in through the rear,
oh,
and they
God.
Have actually taken Secret in the full series 2-1. Shit!
What just happened?